forces on you. The reader will be proud.
a tantrum.
Clive! Where is he? Well, yes.
He is now. But did you see him a few moments ago?
Clive, I don't know how to thank you.
It's all right. We should find him a dry blanket, though. Wouldn't want the little monster catching a cold.
There. He's finally asleep.
The poor thing had a long day.
That makes two of us. So, what happens now?
Now? Now, we make things right.
How?
By providing Walyas what he was denied. A place to learn and grow. A family to love and protect him. So that one day, when the wounds in his heart and mind have finally healed, he might decide for himself how he'd like to live the rest of his life. But until then, I'll stay by his side, come what may.
Then he's a lucky boy. And not only because he'll have the best warrior this side of the belt to teach him the battle axe.
She'll do her best.
Shula. The beast that threatened your home is tamed. The empire that threatened your people toppled. Might it not be time to cast off your ancestors' glamour and retake your place in the Twins?
Perhaps. It's not as if we have the crystals to maintain the wall much longer. But are we truly safe? Is the world truly ready to accept us for who we are and what we believe? If I remember rightly, you and yours still choose to remain hidden, do you not?
We do.
Well, your people will always be welcome in Haven, regardless.
As will yours in the Hideaway. We're allies now. If there's anything you need from us, supplies, food, equipment, do not hesitate to ask.
It's kind of you to offer. But we'll manage, just as we always have. Besides, I suspect you'll be needing everything at your disposal if you're going to save the world.
I fear much of it is past saving. The best we can do is strive to turn what's left into a world where we can all live as equals.
A noble endeavor. And there'll be a place in this world for us, will there? For Walyas.
For everyone. I swear it.
Then we shall be waiting. Until the tides bear you back to shore.